Okay, y'all, so I'm gonna try not to run my mouth and actually talk y'all through everything that I did. So first, I just wanted to point out that these are some tips that I'm trying out. The ones that I'm comparing it to are from Amazon, and they are 3XL. So I would say that these are about 5XL to 6XL. When I got them, it said 10XL, but it's definitely not 10XL. Like, it's not that much longer than 3XL. However, tips come from different companies and they size them differently. So honestly, you'll never know what you're really getting until you get it.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Y'all, I was mad because I started recording. Well, I thought I started recording this part right here, but I did not. But I'm gonna just let y'all listen to the filing. I never knew that y'all listening to filing was a thing. So I'm gonna just let that play out for a second. I was just showing you all right here that you want to get the nails as narrow as possible. So that is why I am filing with my e-file instead of just a hand file. So if you do not have an e-file, you can use some scissors. I would suggest that you get some very sharp scissors. I do have these linked in my Amazon storefront. They are so bomb. I'm pretty sure I have these linked in my Amazon storefront. I either got them from Amazon or from AliExpress. I'm not really sure, but I'm pretty sure I got them from Amazon. And if I didn't, I'm pretty sure that I have some scissors that are just like this that are linked in my Amazon storefront. They are super sharp. I've had them for a while. They have not dulled out, so I highly recommend you get some of these. So on the other side, since I am not left-handed, I'm going ahead and I'm just using my e-file to file the other side. But I did want to show you all that you can do it with scissors. You will just have to go back in with a hand file and smooth it all out after you cut them. So now I'm cutting the tips and I'm literally just cutting off the number. I am not making these any shorter than what I have to make sure that they are all the same length. You're just going to put cuticle to cuticle and make sure that they are all ending at the same point. They were so long, y'all. I could not stop looking at them. I was like, I think these are way a little longer than the last ones that I did. So anyway, we're going ahead and I'm taking my dynamic nail supply file. This is an 8100 grit and these files are bomb, y'all. Like, when I tell you the files that I have been using, I've been using Not Polish 876, some files I got off of Amazon, I think. And these, out of all the ones that I have, are the best. They are very, very sturdy and the grit lasts a very long time. So the colors that I'm gonna be using today are acrylics, cobalt, we have Wicked Mind by Not Polish, and we also have Yellow Mamba. Now, my son actually was the one who picked out these colors.
Pick
a
color. Pick a color.
A color?
Mm-hmm.
For your nails?
Mm-hmm.
Hold up. Let me ask Camden.
Turn that off.
Can I ask Camden?
Yeah.
Yo, Camden.
But you have to turn that down.
Pick a color. Any color. Blue.
Pick a different color.
Red.
Red.
Orange.
Orange.
Yellow.
All right.
So that is where this color scheme came from, y'all. I just went ahead and asked him what color he thinks that I should do, and that is how we came up with these colors. I also went on Pinterest after he told me the colors, and I just typed in literally the colors that he told me and I got this photo from it. So I kind of went off of like an inspo photo of clothing, and the rest was just freestyle off the top of my head. I really did not know what to do with these type of colors. They were things that I've used before. Like I think I just did a black, blue, and orange set that was similar to this, but a shorter version and a little more blinged out. I will link that above right here for you all if you want to go check that out. I did leave this nail in slow-mo, or not slow-mo, real time. I left part of the application in real time just so you all could see how buttery and smooth this acrylic was. This is acrylics. I have reviewed them on my channel before. I will link the video above for you all right here so you can go see kind of like what different color selection she has and all that jazz. But she actually reached out to me on Instagram. I was just randomly like liking a whole bunch of photos because the swatches that she had looked so good that I was actually about to order. But before I could even order, she actually reached out to me and contacted me and sent me over some acrylics, and they were everything that I thought they would be from looking at the swatches on Instagram. So I'm really, really happy that I got to work with this brand. I do not unfortunately have a code with her, but she is working on brand ambassadors, I heard. So maybe one day in the future I will, but as of right now, I don't get any proceeds for promoting her brand or anything like that, but I do stand behind it and say that it is a good brand. I really, really like the consistency of her powders, and I mean, y'all can just see for yourself how it's laying. So just some tips for if you are doing nails that are this long, I would highly, highly, highly suggest that you get a bigger brush. I am using a size 12 brush in this video. However, I feel like to do long nails like this and to get them done in a very timely fashion when you are actually doing a full set, this one hand alone took me about 3 hours to do. So had I done two hands, I feel like it would have took me about probably, I'll say 5 hours, no more than 5 hours. But still, had I had a bigger brush, I feel like I could have laid acrylic a lot faster, since I would have had bigger beads and it would have covered majority of the nail with just two big beads instead of me doing, I don't know how many beads this was, like 4 to 5. So highly suggest that you get a bigger brush, probably I would say a 16 if you're doing size nails with this. Now I cannot use a size 16, but if you want to, if you're somebody who is going to be doing long nails like this very often and that is your specialty, I would suggest learning to work with a bigger size brush. I know people who use size 20s. I don't even know. I can barely use a size 14, y'all. So using a 20 is just crazy to me. But anyway, so but as y'all can see, the application was coming out really, really nicely. Like I had no issues with the application at all in this video. I would just suggest getting a bigger brush so that you can get it done faster. Also, a bigger brush will help you with not having to fill in any gaps. As y'all saw at the bottom, I did have to fill in a few gaps of that nail just because it was a little uneven when I laid the second bead or the third bead. So a bigger brush will help you avoid that because you won't have to double back and fill in any gaps of the nail. But just watch for that and make sure that you are doing it once you're done with the nail and looking back over everything. You always want to make sure that your application is as smooth as possible so that you do not have to do too much filing at the end. I know you all like to see like the ratio of monomer and powder that I am using in videos, but unfortunately the nails were so long that I could not really get everything into the picture without showing y'all my entire desk, which is filthy. So I do apologize about that, and I do have a little snippets of me dipping the brush into the monomer and then into the powder, so y'all will get a little snippet. I'm just not sure of what nail, but anyway, we're going ahead, and I just added a little bit more acrylic right here because I knew that the bead was not going to be big enough. And I'm just this is going to be an ombre nail, so I'm just feathering it upwards to kind of ombre it up, if that makes sense, into nothing at this point. But this is going to give you a better blend and not have such a harsh line, or it look bulky or lumpy when you do place the second bead down. So now I'm going into Yellow Mamba, and let me tell y'all about this acrylic powder. So the two colors that I'm using from Not Polished today are colors that marble. They marble pretty bad, but when you swipe it down on the nail, it completely goes away. So they are usable and they are very, very nice. And they still have a very good consistency once on the nail. So that is why I'm not tripping about it. However, I will say that this acrylic powder right here, Yellow Mamba, it has like almost, okay, you know how you get bags of powdered sugar? That is what this powder feels like. It's only this powder out of all the powders that I have from Not Polished. This is the only one that feels like that when I'm trying to pick it up out of the container. Like for whatever reason, it doesn't pick up correctly. It never has. And then this one right here is similar. Well, it's literally identical to another acrylic powder that I have from Chisel. So if you are looking for a dupe, I would highly suggest that you get the I think it's like Neon 4, if I'm not mistaken, from Chisel. Don't quote me because I don't know for sure, but this one does have a dupe, and I will be soon, very, very soon, making a dupe video. So basically what my dupe video is going to be about is basically higher end acrylic powders. I'm going to be finding you all dupes of those same acrylic powders that are a little cheaper or more affordable, I should say, not cheaper. I feel like when we say cheaper, it gives off the feel that they're not good powders or they're not of good quality, but that is not the case. I've found plenty of good quality powders on my channel, and I have tons and tons of videos about other powders that are of good quality, but just a lot cheaper than these high-end brands. And I'm not shading any high-end brands. I obviously work with them and use the brands a lot. Like, I love their acrylic powders, but some people cannot afford that. So I like to give you all options of different things that you can seek out and buy. So this is like my favorite thing to do. Y'all know, if y'all know me and if y'all been following me for a long time, y'all know I love marble nails. Like, it's something about marble that is just so simple and quick and easy, and it's like the most beautiful look. So I really, really like marble nails. They are super easy, and I personally feel like they are beginner friendly. Like, you can't really mess up a marble. I know people think that is so hard, but y'all, it's really not. And I try to keep the containers in the picture so that y'all can see how I was picking it up. There's not too much liquid in my brush, but there is enough to make the beads just kind of fall down into place. You don't want your beads to be stiff. You do want them to run a little bit, but you do not want them running all over the nail. I know I made a video months ago, y'all, and I really need to delete the video, but I'm not, because it still has views. But I made a video months ago about marble nails and how to marble nails. Y'all, please do not follow that video. Like, if y'all watch that video, just please disregard, because I don't know what I was talking about. I basically was telling y'all to make your beads super, super wet, and if they drip, then that's fine. Which, I mean, technically it is, but if I was to make a video today, it would not be anything like that. So maybe I will in the near future make another video of how I marble with gel polish and with acrylic. But that right there, what I just did, is how I marble with acrylic powder. And it's super easy. The only thing you have to be mindful of is trying to lay it a bit flat. And the reason I say that is because you are going to have to go back and cap marble nails. You will always have to go back and cap acrylic marble nails, because that is not something that you can file over. So when you are capping it, sometimes you can cap it uneven, and that just makes for more work and more filing. So try to make sure that when you are doing the marble, that you are laying it as flat as possible, or as even as possible, I should say. So right here, I'm just going ahead and I am going to ombre the blue into the red, orange, and yellow. I had no idea what I was going for with these nails. Like I said, this was definitely a freestyle. Like, I was really just doing each nail by nail. And even the middle nail wasn't supposed to be how it was. It was not supposed to have any green in it. However, the blue and the yellow were mixing together, and that is how it made green. So if you are trying to, I forgot to tell y'all, if you want to avoid that green spot on the middle nail, the middle finger, then I would suggest that you wait for the yellow to completely dry, and then go ahead with your blue or whatever color that you're gonna do next. Just be mindful when you are ombreing a color into another color, they can mix if you are not waiting long enough to ombre it. Now, I personally do not wait, so that's why it did that. But if you have colors that are like this, where you are using a super, super bright color and then you're using a super dark color, they may mix or they may fade into each other. So you just wanna make sure that the first one is dry before you go in with the second one. Now y'all, I am just convinced that I am no longer good at reverse Frenches. Like, it's just not my thing anymore. I suck at them, to be honest. I'm about to really start just putting the bead down and actually using the French cutter. I feel like it would be a lot easier, even though people say that it's harder. At this point, I feel like I'm gonna try to go back to the French cutter and just use that, because I feel like it would just be a lot quicker. But I mean, I did get through it. Like, I got through it. It was just, and I also think it was the powder, because like I said, this powder is very weird consistency. It is not polished, but I did get this in a giveaway. However, I've heard that Yellow Mamba marbles and is just a weird texture and consistency overall from other people. And the other color that I got from Not Polish Marbles, I'm guessing because it has so much pigment, but the same color that I got from Chisel that looks like Wicked Mine, the red orange one, marbles as well. So you just gotta be mindful that when you're using products that have a lot of pigment in it, you're probably gonna have some of this going on, whether it's drying faster than usual or it's marbling, or you can see kind of the separation in it. Those are just some things that come with very, very pigmented powders. And then sometimes you'll get a super pigmented powder that isn't marbling like that, but it will get caught up in your brush. So there are always cons to super pigmented powders, and you just got to be mindful of where you're getting your powders from and how they work and how to work with them. But with all of that, that actually leads me into saying this. As y'all know, I've been reviewing a lot of small businesses lately, and I brought this up because I'm just talking about, you know, Not Polish being this big brand, and not even Not Polish, like other big brands have acrylic powders that aren't the best sometimes, or they just have a bad batch or whatever. And that's not to say that they're trash, their products are trash, because obviously they're not. Like, we love Not Polish, we love certain things from Kiara Sky, like we love certain things from Valentino. But I say all that to say, stop sleeping on small businesses, you guys. Like, this Acrylic, she is not brand new. However, it's still a small business. She's not completely out there with her business, but this is something that I just recently discovered, and a lot of people had already been using her products, and I very much so am wowed by it. Like, the colors are beautiful, and nothing gets stuck in my brush really. I don't have any separation or marbling. Even the acrylics, if y'all watched that video that I had when she sent me acrylics that she has on her website that are supposedly supposed to marble, she sent me like three, and only one of them had like a slight marble to it, and even that one was still usable and still really, really pretty. So just for her to say that on her website was super dope to me, because letting you know that this selection of acrylic powders do marble, or you might experience marbling and they are discounted, like, I think that's super dope, instead of us just purchasing for full price and not even knowing what we're about to get or what we're about to get into with marbling acrylics like some other brands do. So but anywho, I'm going ahead and I am filing the reverse French or reverse smile line, whatever y'all call it. I'm filing this because you always want to file these before you lay down any more acrylic, because you want it to be perfect and straight, or more crisp, I should say, since this is not straight lines. Now, these right here are straight lines, and this is kind of like color blocking. If I was to put acrylic, like colored acrylic, in between these, then it would be more of a color blocking display or nail. But we're not really doing that today. I just randomly put those there and I thought it looked cool. Like, I really had no vision for this, y'all. Like, I had no vision. I did not know what I was doing. Like, literally was just freestyling each and every nail with no inspo except for the picture that I showed y'all in the beginning, which was really just clothing and the colors that I was using. So yeah, I went ahead and I decided to do this. Now I was gonna put this color all the way from right here down to the blue, however that bead did not make it, obviously. So what I ended up doing was actually a mess up, and y'all will see me kind of like cut out and cut back into a part where I was about to place a bead down, and I was gonna make like a drip on the right side of this nail. However, I started doing it with my size 12 Kolinsky brush, the Panda brush, but I was like, why am I doing that? It is way too big. So I did go ahead and I picked up a dynamic nail supply brush, which is right here, and I just started making little drips. Now the way I did this was the same way that I would place down flower petals. Just put a little small tiny dot of acrylic powder, and then I just kind of made it into a drip. So it was super easy. Y'all can literally like just look at it and see what I'm doing, because I probably can't really explain it too well, but I'm just placing down a small bead of acrylic, and then I'm just kind of feathering it up from the middle, and then I'm closing it in on the sides to make it a little more pointy at the top, like a little raindrop. Now this nail was given very much Winnie the Pooh, his honey in his little pot, but I just kept running with it. So I hope, since I said that, y'all don't envision that for the rest of this style or this nail set, but that is literally like what I was thinking about as I was doing it. I was like, should I change something about this? So I did have to bling it out a little bit at the end because it was looking a little cheesy at this point. If I sound a little tired in this video, I am sorry, y'all. It's like 10 in the morning and I'm going out for breakfast at 12. I've literally been up since 9 p.m. last night, and I was just watching TV, doing my nails. And then I just decided to edit this video right after because everybody was commenting on all the posts that I made on TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, and all that. So I know when I see a set done by somebody and they don't post it till like a week or two later, I'd be so pissed. Like, I'd be like, you can't be posting stuff on Instagram and not give us the full tutorial, because I need to know how it was done. So I had to go ahead and edit it real quick and get it up for y'all, hopefully in the same day. It is Sunday right now, so hopefully I can have it up by Sunday tonight. It's early, it's like 10 o'clock in the morning right now. So hopefully I can get this through this voiceover and get it all edited and everything for you all for later tonight. This polish right here is linked in my Amazon storefront. It is my favorite holographic nail polish. It's by this brand called Fan Zest, and it's super super pretty. So we are going in with Kiera Sky clear powder, y'all. I love this clear acrylic. It is so good. Like, I'm probably gonna invest in getting like a big thing of it. I have never tried nail polishes clear, so I can't really compare the two, but I do have it. I just haven't used it. I've been using the Kiera Sky until I'm done with that, but I really really do like their clear. It's super super clear. I just want to show you all, I kept this in real time so you guys could see it, just how it laid and how to cap nails when you are doing color blocking, or if you have any negative space that does not have any acrylic at all. You just want to make sure that it's even. You're gonna lay it down just as you would any other acrylic bead. That bead right there was literally perfect and even. It laid down like spectacular, chef's kiss. So this is the only nail that I actually cap in the video, and the reason why I did that is because I just feel like capping takes a very long time, and I did not want to like cap every nail in the video. It would just be, you know, repetitive. Like, once you see one nail capped, you will know what to do with the rest, and the rest of the nails were solid. So that is why I chose this nail to cap, just so you could see the most difficult nail to cap being capped. If you've made it this far, let me know down below which nail is your favorite so far. Once we put the bling on the nails, then you might change your mind. But so far, this one was my favorite nail. And when it's all said and done, this one was definitely my favorite nail. And usually my favorite nail is the ring finger or the middle finger. But this time around, I made the pointer finger all jazzed up, and I'm glad that I did. I didn't know that I was gonna do it that way, but Usually the pointer finger is not the one that has the most going on. It's usually my ring finger that I make the most like dramatic, but it just ended up being this way this time. So it all worked out. They all looked really good. I thought they were all very cohesive and went together. Yeah, I just love the set overall. So the only thing that I regret about this set is I wish that on the middle finger, I wish that I would have put my little guns that I have. I have these little fake metal that everybody's using. I don't know if I can find a picture of them. I'll try to find a picture to link it in the screen above for you all right here, so you know what I'm talking about. But I wish I would have had one of those. Well, I do have them. I have them, but I wish I would have thought to put it on my middle finger, and I thought the look would have went crazy had I done that. And I'm so mad that I didn't do it, because I had already taken pictures and I had already posted the video. So if I would have done it now, then it just kind of would have been, you know, a waste of time. But I know for sure I'm definitely going to be making a set that involves those and has those on the nails very, very soon. I kind of already have an idea of what I want to do, so I'm super excited to do another set like that. I also have a set that I am making for the first person who messaged me on Instagram their sizes. I posted on my community post to go ahead and send me pictures of your your finger nail bed sizes using my nail hack that I found on TikTok, but I posted it up here using the nail hack, and somebody already messaged me, so I will be making some press-ons for her. I just had her choose whatever colors that she likes and send me a couple designs so I can get a feel of what she usually goes for, and I will be making those, and I'll probably do a video out of it when I do make her press-ons, just so y'all can see exactly how we did it and how she got sized without me ever having to send a sizing kit. So that might be my next video, because I'm trying to get them sent out to her this week. So yeah. So I did do most of the filing off camera, and the reason being is just because it was going to take too long to be putting it in this camera. The set was already kind of making it a lengthy video, so I didn't want to really incorporate all of that, because y'all see me file and y'all know what to do and how to file. But I didn't have to file too much anyway. I just used my 80 grit and went sidewall to sidewall all the way down the nail, just making them a little more straight. I did use my e-file a little bit just to straighten them up. If you're comfortable with doing that, then you can do that. But after I did that, I just went over all the nails with an 80 grit file, and then I buffed them out. I would suggest that you use a 100 grit file though, not an 80 grit. And after I buffed everything out, I went ahead and washed my hands to get all the dust off, and I'm gonna be using the top coat by iGel Beauty. Y'all know this is my go-to top coat now. I love it so much. I'm so glad that I got it in my mystery boxes. If you haven't checked out my mystery boxes, go ahead and check those out. I have tons of them. I have like 8. I think I did 8 mystery boxes. So yeah, go ahead and just type my name in Nail to the Hustle and search mystery box, and it should pop up for you. I was really debating on whether or not I should keep this part in or not, because like, do y'all care to see top coating? I don't think I really care to see top coating. Well, sometimes I do. I don't know. Y'all let me know down below if y'all even care to see top coating in videos at the end. I left one or two nails in here so y'all can see it, but I did go ahead and top coat all the nails first before bling, and then I'm just going to file off the parts that I'm going to be putting the bling at. So I don't typically do this, but I just wanted to try something different, and it worked out okay. I did end up having to top coat a little bit more again, so I feel like next time I'm just gonna do it the way that I usually do it, which is just simply place down the bling before top coating and then secure the gems with top coat. So this way is okay, but I don't suggest it. So I am going to be using the Beatles Rhinestone Gem Glue. Now, this glue, I cannot give you a full review on it because I have never worn a full set and like actually worn it for weeks at a time with using this glue. Now I do know for sure the McCart Rhinestone glue really, really works well. And this is supposed to be a dupe for that. So, but I cannot stand behind that statement. Like, I don't know if it really is a dupe for the McCart Rhinestone glue. And I love the McCart Rhinestone glue. I used to use it on my clients a lot, but then I switched over to Zuley's glue and the Dynamic Nail Supply 3-second glue. So I haven't been using it too much lately, and I actually broke the bottle, so I ended up throwing the McCart glue away. However, it did work really, really well, and I highly suggest if you are looking for a cluster glue or a rhinestone gem glue or gel glue, whatever they call it, McCart is a great one to purchase. Now, if you are looking for something that's a little cheaper and more affordable and something that you can get on Amazon, then Beatles Rhinestone glue, like I said, I heard that it is a dupe for the McCart glue. Now on this nail, I actually did put some caviar beads around some of the rhinestones, but I don't believe I showed me putting down the caviar beads in this video just because this nail alone was very time consuming. I actually edited out a lot because I just was rearranging the stones if they were slipping and sliding, realigning them and adding, taking away. So this was actually cut short and it was still a long process. I ended up flipping those stones and I cut that part out, but overall it was just a very tedious thing to do on camera, so I did kind of cut it short. And I did not show me placing the stones at the top of some of my nails, like the pinky, the middle finger, I think, and my thumb. I didn't show that, but I did want to show this placement right here, just because I've only done this placement like once or twice, and it's pretty common on a reverse French and super pretty and simple. I did end up towards the end, you're gonna see me add more stones to the French line or the smile line, because at first I was just gonna make it kind of a short one, but then I ended up adding stones to the smile line to make it a deeper French. Instead of using the regular diamond studded one, I went ahead and used the one that looks like a teardrop or a raindrop. I thought it went with the nail really well and it was really cute. So then I went ahead and added some stones on the bottom where the blue part was, the blue color blocking or whatever you want to call it. I did go ahead and add some stones right there, and I only showed you one line because I did the same exact thing to the second one, and then I just straightened them all out. As soon as you get the stones exactly where you want them, you want to go ahead and cure like right after so that they don't move or slide anymore. And when you are putting them in the light, make sure that nothing is moving around. This is why you have to really be careful with rhinestone glue instead of using, or cluster glue or whatever, instead of using like Zuley's bling adhesive or something that dries quicker while you're still looking at it and working with it. Because when you put it in the light and when you turn your hand, one of the studs or anything can go out of place and it will just mess up the whole design. And once you have to pick it off and do all that, it's just a mess. But anyway, you guys, this is how the set came out. I thought it was super, super cute. Now remember, I said I wish I would have put the little clip on the middle finger, but I did not think about it until after the set was completely done. But nonetheless, I hope you guys enjoy this video and I hope you guys do some recreations or something like that. Let me know if you've ever done a set this long before. But yeah, I will see y'all in the next video. I love y'all so much. Mwah. Bye.